What's up guys, thank you so much for tuning in. So for today's video, I'll be telling you guys all about my med hold experience, my Air Force med hold experience, that is. As you guys know, I did get disqualified from the Air Force while I was at BMT, so you're probably wondering, so where did you go during that time being? Did they take you straight home? What is med hold? Let me just go ahead and tell you what med hold is. Med hold is a place where trainees or airmen that graduated go in their transitioning phase. So like some people that have graduated and they're airmen, they are at med hold as well, but they're waiting on either results from a waiver or just something had got messed up in their transition process. So they're waiting on that to get handled. For trainees, it's either for you to recover, like if you have a really bad injury, you're gonna be there to recover for a certain period of time. But if you're there for too long, then they'll kick you out. Or like if the recovery is taking too long, then you'll have to get kicked out. Or like if you fail your PT test, you're gonna get there and wait and see if they want you, if they'll let you retake your PT test, meaning you'll have to get recycled back to third week of training and take that PT test there. It's kind of like a holding cell. I'm just gonna say that you're gonna be there to wait basically on what's gonna happen. Or if you have bad results from a test or something, if you failed your drug test or your blood came back, you have HIV or something crazy like that. Or if you are in my situation and it's this thing called BAS, and that's for your mental health, and they determine if you're mentally fit to be in the Air Force or not. I know I was mentally fit to be in the Air Force, but the way that they worded everything was like weird, so I answered it honestly. They deemed that as not for the Air Force or something. Whatever. I'm over it. I might rejoin, I might not. We'll have to see. But let me tell you guys, once they told me that I had got disqualified, I had to leave my squadron and go to med hold, which is the 737 training squadron. And so when I first got there with one of my wingmen, I told you guys I didn't like her. It doesn't really matter at this point. But when I first got there, we took the bus because she couldn't walk for some odd reason. And you get in process at the TIC or TIC. And you go in there and you get your 5-minute phone call to tell whoever you need to tell that you've been in process at med hold and you'll be there for whatever amount of time. So when you get there, you'll also get questioned if you want to fight your case or if you want to just go ahead and get sent home. I wanted to fight my case at first, but then I was told that you were going to be there for a long period of time and it might not even come back with the way that you want it to come back. So I just said, send me home. I'll try again, I'll do, you know, something else. It's just, I'm not gonna waste time just sitting here knowing that the results will not come back the way that I want them to. So yeah, after your phone call, you get your straps for your backpack for the 737 training wing, and you get this thing called volunteer hours and stuff, sheets where you write down stuff that you do for volunteer work, and you get more hours added or more minutes added to your phone call. I didn't really care about that. I knew that I wasn't gonna be there that long, so. Also, when you go into the TIC, you get your bed sheets and your pillow. So yeah, I got all that. And then we went upstairs to meet the girls in our dorm. And the dorm is just, like I said, full of different type of people with different cases, people that are fighting their cases, people that have been there for a hot minute, and people that have just arrived just like you. And so the dorms are connected to the airmen's dorm. So your dorm, so where the trainees go is separated from the airmen's. So it's always gonna be girls though. So it's like a group of female airmen and female trainees and then male trainees and then male airmen. So they have their own separate dorms. So it's like connected to whatever.
I'm terrible at explaining stuff, but basically the airman's dorm is literally connected to the trainees dorm. Literally, that's it.
So yeah. So when I first got there, I did notice right off the bat that a lot of the girls there are like moody. Very moody. Not all of them. Some of them were really good. But some of the girls, majority of the girls there are gonna have like different moods. They've been there for a long time, so they're ready to either leave or get back into training. So it's just a bunch of different emotions. It's worse than being on the line or being while you're in training because you're all there with a reason and you're kind of pretty much motivated to continue on and your training and everything. But when you're at med hold, people have so many different reasons as to why they're there, and some of them are valid because not a, you know, some people get kicked out for a reason because they are actually do have some mental problems that are detrimental to their Air Force career, and I could definitely see that, but that wasn't me. So that was another reason why I felt odd being there, because I was like, I don't belong here, I belong back in training, you know. But I got over that fast. Within 2 days after that, I was about ready to go home. So yeah. When I got there, one of my friends also that was in the process of leaving the Air Force was there, so I was happy to see her because she was from my first flight, and I was like, very excited to see a familiar face. But she also left like a couple days later. I was pretty sad, but she was able to show me the ropes within the period of time that I was there. Also in MedHold, a lot of people say it's good, a lot of people say it's bad, a lot of people have a mixed emotion about it, but the good thing about MedHold is that you do get a TV. There's this thing called cable time, so if you pass your inspections, you get your cables, which is the cable cord that goes to your TV so you can hook it up and watch TV to begin with. So you get to watch TV, and since the MTIs, there is no MTI for your dorm. Like, cause you know when you're in training, you have your MTI in your dorms with you. So there's no dorm MTI, there's no MTI in your dorm the majority of the time. They barely come up, so you get a lot of nap time. There's no cameras except for in the day room. The first couple days I was just kind of sad because I really wanted to be with my flight. I just didn't, you know, like the fact that I was in med hold and that the whole situation had happened to me to begin with. So I was kind of sad, but I didn't let it out on anybody. I was still positive and just talking to people still. But the majority of the time I was there, I was trying to like just sleep. Sleep is very comforting to me, so I just wanted to sleep a lot. I had a lot of nap time and I really enjoyed it. That pushed the happy endorphins, you know, that made me feel more comfortable being there and also watching TV. After your first arrival of getting there, the next day or the next morning, you're gonna get signed with a caseworker and she's gonna help you either fight your case or get you shipped out of there. That's what happened to me as far as my case is concerned. And when you are guard or reserve, they'll get you sent out of there really fast. When you are active duty, it's gonna take like a week. So that's how long it pretty much took for me. And I just talked with her on the phone, told her I wanted to just go ahead and get sent home. And it was a very quick thing like that. I just went right upstairs after that. And then you have to go and get a physical done. And that's where you get your dead man's waiver. It's a waiver that permits you from marching and doing exercises and all that extra stuff. So you have to walk everywhere. Usually they would get on you if you don't march. So you just have to say you have a waiver. But I just bit the bullet when I was around my squadron. When I had to pick up clothes for my squadron, I just bit the bullet and just marched because like, what's the worst that could happen? Who cares? Also, I remember while I was there, it didn't make sense why they had everybody in this one dorm with all these different types of reasons as to why they are here. Like there could be a not very safe or mentally stable person in this room that they had to send home, but we got to sleep with them. Is very, very dangerous. A lot of people, when they get sent home or they get told these news, they're very mad. So anything can happen, like literally anything can happen, but they're gonna just cram you in a dorm with someone that's not mentally there, somebody that they know has actual mental issues. And just because they can, just because you're all gonna get sent home or you're all, you know, dealing with the case or something, it's just not good at all. And while I was there, they would like share these little stories about some, like, you know, crazy people that were actually in med hold with everybody. It was like a witch type of person or like a racist person that just wasn't supposed to be in there, and you're gonna get packed with all these different types of races. That's very, very dangerous. But they don't think about this stuff when they send you home. They don't think about how med hold is for these people. It could be depressing for a lot of people. For a lot of people it wasn't. You could tell that it showed on their face. So like, you're gonna go through the motions while you're in med hold, but you also wanna keep busy. I kinda did, but I kinda really just tried to sleep my way through it or just like watch TV, mind my own business. When somebody needed me to do something, sometimes I would, you know. It's just a mental work while you're in med hold because you're already, like I said, you're feeling a certain way because you already had to leave the Air Force or, you know, the Air Force, yeah. So it's just like, you're just gonna go through the motions. You're gonna really wanna be home at that point because you're gonna feel like you're stuck and you don't know why it's taking so long to get you processed out. This one girl wanted to leave. My good sis Dangles, I love you girl, I miss you. She was there for a very long time and they were taking their sweet time to get her. I felt so bad, but she finally got out. My good sis is free, period. So when you're in med hold, you still have to have your reporting statements on. Like, you still have to respect your MTIs because there will be MTIs around in the med hold area, but you still have to respect them and, you know, say yes sir, yes ma'am, and so forth. But if you do slip up on your reporting statement at least once in the conversation, you will be fine. They can't yell at you while you're in med hold also, because a lot of people have anxiety issues that do come into med hold. You know, they won't do the most like the MTIs in training. So that's a plus, I guess. But yeah, speaking of, you still have inspections to do. I had got put into an Alcatraz dorm and I was not used to the Alcatraz dorms. So like, everything is just completely different. Since I was in Alcatraz dorm, I started off mopping and stuff. That easily got old. I did not like it. So I moved to doing the chrome, and the chrome is a lot more easier. It's a lot more chill. You can get it done and just go about your day. The chrome is like the silver piece. You have to like wipe it down with this polish and stuff. I like that a lot more better. A lot better. Grammar. Where is it? And the inspections are a little bit easier in my opinion, but it's easier, but the girls really don't try because they're just, either it's their day that they're leaving or they just don't care anymore and it's just like whatever. But that's what makes it bad, because a lot of girls just don't try or they don't care. The other people are actually here and they're trying to go back to training, so they're gonna be here a lot longer, but they don't care, so they're not gonna really do a good job to get you your course. It is gonna keep you sane, you know? So that's the hard part about it. I left at a good time because they got a new MTI for the dorm. It was a dude, but he was being a try hard because he was a new MTI, and the lady was like trying to be on him. Like, she was trying to do the absolute most. This once, I really did not like this lady, y'all. I did not like this lady. One time at Chow, she like really made me mad. At Med Hold, since you're in an Alcatraz dorm, I think that's the reason or something. They had actual silverware. I did not like that at all. Very much unsanitary. We are still in a panoramic, and we had plates and everything, glass cups and everything. Very gross to me. You have to have three liquids, I think, or two liquids or something. I can't remember, but you had to fill it up, and I usually didn't drink all of it. The other MTIs, male MTIs, see, male MTIs are just nicer. They really didn't care that much, but she cared. And so I had a little bit of water in my, in two of my cups, like halfway. And she's like, "Trainee, sit down and finish your liquids." I was like, "Girl," I kept going. She's like, and she repeated it again. And I was like, "Oh my gosh." Like, that's so annoying. Like, that's, what is the reason? We're not in training. You don't have to do the most. Like, what is your purpose? I'm not gonna die. I have a water bottle upstairs. I'm not gonna die from drinking water. I'm not even doing extensive activities, so there's no reason for you to be on us about this hydration. Like, there's no reason. But I sat down and drank my liquids. It was very gross because I didn't really think the cups were clean. That's why I didn't finish it to begin with. So yeah, I was very much upset about that. Chow Hall was dirty, in my opinion. I didn't really like it. The forks were like nasty, and the stuff was just not clean the way it was supposed to be. But the food was still good. I guess some days it really wasn't. Like, one day I had expired wheat bread, and it didn't even taste like actual wheat bread. It tastes like it was made with chemicals or something. It didn't do anything for me. I didn't really like the food that much. All I really ate was peanut butter, period. Like, you would never catch me a day at BMT, period, without peanut butter. Like, at the end of the day, your best bet is a peanut butter and jelly sandwich. Some days they would not have jelly, and then when they mess up the bread, that's just the last straw for you. That's your 13th reason. Like, well, yeah, you still have to be quiet during chow. Everything's pretty much the same, but you just can't easily dump off your food, so you have to like go in the thing and like dump it off. I don't know if that's how it's like at the actual Alcatraz dorms when you're in actual training, but I didn't like it at all. As I was talking about the freedom aspect of Med Hold, you do get more trips to Mini Mall, and you get to go to the Big BX some days, like especially if you're leaving, so you can get your suitcase if you need one and all this other type of stuff. I bought AirPods while I was in Med Hold because I just felt like I needed them, and it was a reward to myself, just something to cheer me up. I needed AirPods just cause. So you can definitely rack up on some cough drops. You can buy some new shoes if you want, some new clothes, whatever really. I tried to keep it light because I knew when it was time to leave, I did not want to carry anything heavy, and I didn't want to be able to stuff everything that I could in my bags. So you do get frequent trips to the BX, and when you do get your trips to the BX, keep in mind that you're gonna be bored while you're in Med Hold. Like, you're gonna be extremely bored, and that's what drives a lot of people insane. So you want to get some crossword puzzles, some magazines, some coloring books, anything that you can to keep you occupied. I forgot every time that I would go to get those things, so I would just draw in my book and write like a lot. I wrote a lot. Just, that's all you need to do. I always was writing what I was craving, because I was always craving food. I always wrote what I would want to do when I get out, everything, even this right here. Also, you still have to wake up at 5:45 a.m. and that's just where you go downstairs and you go under the atrium and you do assembly. Make sure everyone is accounted for. Some MTIs will go up to the dorms to make sure nobody's still sleeping. Then y'all will recite the Air Force song and say the Airman's Creed. and then they will brief you on whatever you have to do or whatever's gonna go on throughout the day at that very moment. If there's nothing going on, then they won't say anything, and then it'll give something to the dorm chief. Doesn't really matter, I didn't really care. And then you'll go back upstairs and you'll start on your details, and after you do your details, that's when you go to breakfast, chow, and then okay, and then after chow you'll go back and finish your details. And once you're done with your details, an MTI should come up and inspect your dorm and either give you your cords or not give you your cords. And throughout the day, everyone's just going around doing going to appointments and doing other stuff that they have to do, this and the third, you know, da da da. Still have to do duty flights sometimes. I only really did it once with this group because I was only there for like a week and a half. Also, CQ isn't as scary, so like when you're going into CQ, usually it's, you have to be super duper, you know, I don't even know what the word is, super duper, I don't know what the word is. Like, you have to walk a certain way and do this and then do that and have to be super duper respectful. You still have to be respectful, but like not as strict. It's not as strict as it was when you're in training. So you don't have to be scared to go to CQ. I was never scared to go to CQ all the while I was here at MedHold. Also, you don't have a laundry crew really, because you all have to do your own laundry. Thank God. That's the only thing I loved about being in MedHold, not having to go through the whole laundry thing. But you still have to do linen exchange, but it wasn't as bad. I don't think it's as bad as doing it when you're in training. Nothing is as bad as when you're in training, because training is just a whole nother story. You guys know, you can watch the video I recently uploaded, and period. And then I did have to turn in my OCPs and dress blues. That was like very, very sad for me on the inside. I never show anything. I rarely show my emotions. Especially while I'm at BMT, because they teach you not to show your emotions and stuff. I was very sad actually to turn in my OCPs. I forgot one of my hat and my OCP trousers, but I have one of them still, so that's good. They let you keep a certain amount of stuff. So like, I kept my boots and the little dress blue shoes and a couple name patches, and I kept my PT clothes, and I kept some of my Coyote t-shirts, and yeah, and my socks. I also want to show you guys something I got from the mini mall. Hold on one second. So I got this little girl from the mini mall. This little teddy bear is so cool. It's like, it has the flight cap, the little tap shoes, so cute. Everything can come off too, so that's really cool. Like, I can unbutton her shirt and everything, but I don't want to do all that. It's so cute. I don't really know what else I have to say about MedHold. It's definitely another adjustment, I promise you. It's not super duper horrible, but it's not cool as well, because you don't want to be there. You just don't want to be there. So whatever you do while you're in training, do everything you can to not go to MedHold. It's not that bad, but just do everything you can to not have to go to MedHold. I still have a couple more Air Force videos I want to push out to you guys, like how to prepare for BMT, a new BMT packing list. If y'all have any suggestions, because I pretty much have been through a lot with this experience, if y'all have any questions whatsoever about BMT, any questions whatsoever about the ASVAB test, how to study for it, I might push that a video out like that. If you guys want to see that, please let me know down in the comment section. And again, thank you guys so much for watching. If you enjoyed the video, please don't forget to leave a like, comment down below any video suggestions you guys have, and peace.